Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and this is the memory of a Pandora radio station. And I like to do this because it's a really fascinating thing to me how something like, you know, the internet radio, something like Pandora works. How it works, how it picks the next song, and it assumes that I'll like, you know, what it chooses for me. How all that works is magical to me. It's really fascinating. And I know Pandora saves up to, like, you know, it has a history. It keeps this history up of the songs that it picked for you. And 20 songs. It'll keep 20 songs up there, the previous song. So this is like the memory of a Pandora station. Really, Pandora isn't the only radio station that does this. There's a whole bunch of other services or apps that does this. There's like Last.fm. There's iHeartRadio. There's TuneIn Radio. But I guess I just personally have always been more experienced with Pandora radio station. And I'm not a big fan of iHeartRadio. I haven't really used, TuneIn Radio all that much. Last.fm I used a bunch of times on my friend's Xbox 360, and I thought that was, it's a really cool service, but I've never really used it on the phone, so I don't know. But anyway, this is the memory of a Pandora station. Depending on, like, I always like to see what songs come next after I dumb it down or dumb it up, or if I just do nothing, because, you know, if I dumb it up, it's kind of like, oh yeah, I'm totally cool, I want to listen to the song again and when it comes up. If I don't do anything, it's just like, I don't really care, like, it's a song I'm neutral about, like, I don't really like the song, but I don't hate the song, and I don't mind if I listen to it again. And then when I dumb it down, that's usually like, I don't ever want to listen to the song again on this station. This song and this station just does not belong. And I think Pandora does a really good job of that, like determining what song you want to hear next. I think Pandora is pretty amazing, but it's weird, like, where Pandora leads to. It's anybody's guess, really. So this is a memory of a Avril Lavigne station. So that's the artist I put in, Avril Lavigne, and seeing what happens. Unfortunately, this isn't the very first time, so it's not like, it's not a blank slate. There is a bunch of songs that I did dumb up and dumb down before I started taking this record of 20 songs. But it seems like, for the most part, whenever I went to Avril Lavigne station, Pandora just wanted me to listen to Taylor Swift, Kelly Clarkson, and Vanessa Carlton. Those have been really the most common, you know, artists that came up afterwards. But this is what happened in this particular instance. So I start the station. The first song that Pandora gives me is by Avril Lavigne, and the song is Things I'll Never Say. It's one of her very first songs that she ever made as an artist, and it's a song I actually really like. I actually like this song. Not one of my favorites from Avril Lavigne, but definitely I like it, so I dumbed it up. The second song comes from Demi Lovato, and the song is Nightingale. I've actually never heard this song before, so I like it when Pandora introduced me to a song that I never heard before, and it's not bad. I don't like it that much, but I don't not like it. And then the third song, of course, I'm just like, come on, Pandora, really? Taylor Swift, and the song is Teardrops on My Guitar, and I'm not a huge fan of Taylor Swift, like, and this song in particular I didn't like, so I gave it a thumbs down. And I think this is the part where I guess I dumbed it down. Pandora does this thing where if you dumb down an artist twice or more than twice, you will most likely never see a song from that artist again on that station. And this must have been the instance that made that happen, because Taylor Swift, I like never experienced her again on this station after this. So that's probably what did it. But before this, man, I was getting Taylor Swift all the time. It was ridiculous. Like, Avril Lavigne, I get it. Like, Taylor Swift, sometimes on some of her songs, she does kind of sound like Avril Lavigne, and Avril Lavigne kind of sounds like Taylor Swift, even though the two have completely different styles. But, like, Pandora was just like, if you like Avril Lavigne, you must like Taylor Swift, and just forcing it out on me. That was really weird. Fourth song was by Avril Lavigne, which is surprising that, like, because usually when you pick an artist station, Pandora usually doesn't give you that same artist so much, but, like, Avril Lavigne happens again. Fourth song was by Avril Lavigne, and the song is Don't Tell Me. It's not, like, one of her best, but I still like that song. I don't know why, but I actually really like Avril Lavigne's songs. I guess it must be because I kind of grew up with her songs. Whatever. Fifth song is Maroon 5. I like the artist, but I didn't like the song Lucky Strike. So I dumbed that down. Next song comes from Avril Lavigne again. And the song is Smile. And I dumbed this down. I did not like the song. I like a lot of Avril Lavigne songs, but I guess her more recent songs, I'm not too big fan of. So, thumbs down. Song 7. Another Avril Lavigne song. That's surprising. Like, Pandora is giving me a lot of Avril Lavigne here. And the song is Too Much to Ask, which I actually really like. So, I thumbed that up. Next song comes from the 8th song is Vanessa Carlton song. And it's 1,000 Miles. When I first heard this song, I really liked the song. But like now, like I don't know why, but like I'm really neutral towards it, so I didn't dumb it up or dumb it down. I really like the piano of this song, like the piano tunes. But it does kind of get repetitive and boring, so I don't know. I might dumb it down later in the future if it comes up again. 9th song is from Kelly Clarkson, and the song is My Life Would Suck Without You. Yeah, for some reason, Pandora really wants me to listen to Kelly Clarkson, just like it really wants me to listen to Taylor Swift. No thank you, Pandora. No thank you. I dumbed this down. I am not a big fan of Kelly Clarkson at all. Number 10, Evanescence. I guess she's a female artist. Sure, like, and the song is Immortal. It kind of makes sense. It's a ballad. It's not like her Evanescence, like, super rock songs. I like Immortal, so I thumbed it up, but I, like, hesitantly, because I don't know if I should be thumbing up Immortal in an Avril Lavigne station. I don't know where this will lead. Really weird there. I don't know why it gave me Evanescence on an Avril Lavigne station. Weird, right? Pandora does weird things sometimes. Song number 11, from Michelle Branch. This is actually expected. It's not out of the left field. And the song is All You Wanted. Not a bad song. Not horribly, like, I don't really dig the song all that much, but it's a pretty cool song. I'm neutral. I didn't thumb it up or thumb down. Song number 12, Lifehouse. What? You give me Lifehouse, Pandora? Like, what was that about? And the song is You and Me. There's only one song ever that I liked from Lifehouse. I don't remember the name of it, but if I hear it, I'll know it. But this song was not one of them. I dumbed it down. Lifehouse, not a big fan. To me, this is like one of the most repetitive sounding band ever. But yeah, that's what it gave me. Weird. And then 13, The Fray, and the song is How to Save a Life. Like, this song appears in all my stations. It is weird. This song has appeared in my Ben Folds station, has appeared in my Yellow Card station. It's appeared, like, I guess it hasn't appeared in, like, different genres. You know, I have a Guns N' Roses station, and I have a Beastie Boys station, and I have a Tupac station. But, of course, you're not going to find The Fray in those stations. But it's like every other station that's, like, soft rock or ballad or popish, like, The Fray pops up, and the song How to Life comes up so much in my other stations. It's funny how Pandora loves to promote these songs to me. And every time, like, I don't mind listening to it, but I don't like the song that much. So I always not doing anything. I don't dumb it up or dumb it down. Song 14 is from Katy Perry. Interesting. I haven't heard too many Katy Perry stuff. I don't know how to feel. I don't really have much of an opinion on her because I haven't heard a lot of her songs. But the song is Teenage Dream. Definitely did not like the song. Never heard the song before Pandora made me listen to it. Not a big fan. Dumbed it down. Song 15 from Kelly Clarkson again. Look, I dumbed down Kelly Clarkson so much. I don't know why I keep coming up. The song is Mr. Know-It-All. Yeah, I dumbed that down. Not a big fan of that song. Song 16 is from Michelle Branch, again, and Are You Happy Now? So, another one of those songs where I don't care for too much, but I don't hate it. So, neutral again. Song 17 is, again, from The Fray. And I've never actually listened to this song before, actually, or have I? How does the song go again? But anyway, this is the song "You Found Me." Oh yeah, no, I remember the song. And this song actually comes up a lot. So, not surprised. It's kind of odd that it comes up in an Avril Lavigne station of all stations, but I like it. I actually like this song, so I thumbed it up. And song 18, we're almost at the end, folks. Song 18 is from Christina Perry, and the song is "Jar of Hearts." I've heard this song before, but in a completely different station. I think I heard it before in my Marie Digby station. Yeah, I had that station. I'm not ashamed. But yeah, I kind of like it, but I don't really like it, so I didn't give anything to it. And number 19, song 19 is, again, another Katy Perry song. So now Pandora is really trying to shove down Katy Perry to me. And the song is "Wide Awake," and I've never heard the song before Pandora had me listen to it. I don't mind it, actually. It did have its annoying parts, but I was okay with it. So I didn't thumb it up or thumb it down. And finally, the last song on this memory of a Pandora station, Pandora gave me "Lifehouse" again. What the hell? And the song that it gave me was "Halfway Gone." Ugh, definitely thumbs down. Like, I hope from this point on, like, on an Avril Lavigne station, like, I get "Lifehouse," Katy Perry, and "Evanescence." Like, those are just weird choices that Pandora is giving me. I like how Pandora wants to kind of expand this genre of music, but, like, it's weird. Like, sometimes Pandora does weird things, and I think these 20 songs that happened, this memory that happened, this memory of a Pandora station is kind of weird. But at least, well, I don't know. I don't know if it's better that I didn't get so much Taylor Swift. But that was funny. I think the previous songs previous 20 songs before these, almost all of them were like Taylor Swift, Vanessa Carlton, and Kelly Clarkson. Those three were huge in this station. I think I've pretty much written off Taylor Swift by this point. Kelly Clarkson is still coming up. Vanessa Carlton seems to be pretty much over with. I don't know. But yeah, it's always fascinating to me how Pandora works. I know the system is like an algorithm of, you know, they have based on like, they take like phrases out of a song, like, oh, this song has this tone with these kind of lyrics, and then like, they put them in this algorithm system and the computer just try to figure out which song you want to hear next. It's magical. Like, it's amazing how it does it. So yeah, that's a memory of a Pandora radio station. I actually want to do another video where it's not Pandora, but I compare it to iHeartRadio. iHeartRadio, I don't know what algorithm they use, but iHeartRadio does strange things. Seriously, like, their Avril Lavigne station, like, it'll start with the song by Avril Lavigne, but by the 10th song, where it ends up is just like, how the hell did it end up here? You know, I think iHeartRadio, that's why I really don't like it, just because it's so random. At least with Pandora, I can see kind of the progression of what it thinks that I like, you know. But yeah, I think it's interesting how Pandora works, and I hope that this was a good demonstration of, you know, I guess my musical taste and how Pandora chose its songs depending on my musical taste. But yeah, if you have any thoughts, feel free to share. Happy to, you know, to read your thoughts and maybe respond to them. So yeah, cheers.